بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. حديث لسن نمبر 11. عن أبي ذر رضي الله تعالى عنه قال: قلت يا رسول الله أوصني. قال: إذا عملت سيئة فأتبعها حسنة تمحها. قال: قلت يا رسول الله، أمن الحسنات لا إله إلا الله؟ قال: هي أفضل الحسنات. رواه أحمد. In this narration, Abu Dharr radiallahu ta'ala anhu asks Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Messenger of Allah, advise me. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, when you commit a sin, follow it up with a good deed, as a good deed will eliminate the evil deed, the bad deed. Abu Dharr radiallahu ta'ala anhu then inquired, Ya Rasulullah, is the recitation of La ilaha illallah from amongst the righteous acts, the good deeds? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, it is the choicest of righteous acts, it is the best of good deeds. From this hadith, similar to the previous one, in the sense that when a person does an evil deed, if he commits an act of sin, then he should follow it up with a good deed. That's part of his tawbah. So in this hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam repeats this advice, that when you do something wrong, then tawbah, part of the tawbah is to follow it up with a good deed. So hasana is a good deed. Abu Dharr radiallahu ta'ala anhu asked that Ya Rasulullah, is la ilaha illallah from the good deeds, hasanat, from the good deeds? Prophet says this is the best of the good deeds. How can we link it to the first part of the hadith? So what we learn from this, that as la ilaha illallah is from the best of good deeds, the choicest of righteous acts, then when someone commits a sin, when someone does something wrong, when someone's involved in haram and he does tawbah, after that a person should excessively read La ilaha illallah, because this is part of the, this is one of the choicest deeds, one of the best acts of ibadah. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in one hadith, he says that أَفْضَلُ ذِكْرِ لَا إِلَهَ اللَّهِ, that the best dhikr is La ilaha illallah. So La ilaha illallah, there's many, many virtues for La ilaha illallah. But just to suffice with one, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he asked, Ya Rasulullah, tell me a special dhikr. So Prophet Allah azza wa jal said to Musa alayhi salam, okay, the special dhikr for you, well, the special dhikr is La ilaha illallah, recitation of La ilaha illallah. Musa alayhi salam said, Ya Rasulullah, Musa alayhi salam said, oh Allah, everyone says La ilaha illallah, give me something special, special for me. Allah Azza wa Jal replies that La ilaha illallah is so great, so powerful, that if the heavens and the earth were all to be put in one scale and La ilaha illallah was to be put on another scale, then La ilaha illallah would outweigh the weight of the heavens and the earth. So we know that the recitation of La ilaha illallah is very, very dear to Allah Azza wa Jal. It weighs greatly on the scales of the Day of Judgment. So a person should recite La ilaha illallah as much as possible. There's a weak hadith which says, but for fadail and virtues, weak hadith are okay. But a person who recites La ilaha illallah 100 times daily, then on the Day of Judgment, Allah Azza wa Jal will illuminate his face, and it will shine like the 14th moon, which we know is very bright. So Allah Azza wa Jal give us a tawfiq to act on this. So if when someone does something wrong, even if someone doesn't do something wrong, then a person should keep his tongue moist with the dhikr of La ilaha illallah. Inshallah, I make intention of reciting La ilaha illallah as much as I can. Allah Azza wa Jal give us tawfiq. Jazakallah.